Hello friends, we will be continuing with the reasoning sessions. Here we will be discussing the following topics: comparison of ranks, blood relations, family tree, and conditions and groupings. We will be taking one example from each topics so that we can better understand the topic. Now here is the example for comparison of ranks. Now the questions: Monica is at 25th place from one end in group of 35 students. What is her position from the other end? So from one end she is at 25th place. So what is the position from the other end? 25th position means 24 persons are before, and one position is occupied by herself, and from the other side 10 people are there. So from the other side, 10 plus 1 herself, she is occupying the 11th place. The shortcut method can be total person plus 1 minus position from one side is equal to position from the other side. So here total persons were 35 plus 1, which is 36, minus 25, which means 11th. So 11th position is our answer. Now we will come to blood relations. Now there are three types of questions that can be asked in these. The first type is deciphering jumbled up descriptions. In this type of questions, a roundabout description is given in the form of certain small relationships, and direct relationship between the persons concerned is to be deciphered. Example 1. Pointing out to a lady, Rajan said she is the daughter of the woman who is the mother of the husband of my mother. So who is the lady to Rajan? The relations may be analyzed as follows. Mother's husband is father. Father's mother is grandmother. Grandmother's daughter, father's sister. Father's sister is equal to aunt. So the lady is Rajan's aunt. Moving on to the type 2 questions. Relation puzzle. In this type, mutual blood relations or other informations of more than two persons are mentioned, and information about any two is mentioned. A and B are brothers, C and D are sisters, A's son is D's brother. How is B related to C? Clearly, B is the brother of A, A's son is D's brother. This means D is the daughter of A. Since C and D are sisters, C is also the daughter of A. So B is the uncle of C. Quickly moving on to the third type, coded puzzles. Here the relationships are represented by certain codes or symbols such as plus, minus, and so on. Then the relationship between certain persons given in the form of these codes are to be analyzed. If A plus B means A is the sister of B, A minus B means A is the brother of B, A into B means A is the daughter of B. Which of the following shows the relation that E is the maternal uncle of D? Now we have to check each option for same. Clearly, E is the maternal uncle of D means D is the daughter of the sister of E. That is option C. Now we come to the next topic, which is family tree. Now here is the example. B is F's daughter-in-law. D is A's only grandchild. C is D's only uncle. A has only two children, F and C. One of them is male and another is female. E is the father of C. Now B is F's daughter-in-law, thus indicating B is a female. Now we will take a circle to denote female and a rectangle to denote Male. Second statement indicates A being a top, the top of the tree, but doesn't indicate about gender of either of the two. C is male, indicated by the third statement. Now, A has two children, F and C, indicates F is the daughter and C is the son, but we are not sure about A's gender yet. So A is here, C and F. Again, E is the father of C, indicates E is a male and father of C, and also that A is a female and wife of E. So E father, E mother, A mother, and C and F, again D and B are here. So this completes the family tree. And we can now answer any question based on this tree. Next topic is conditions and groupings. Here some conditions are given and we have to group the team based on those conditions. Now here is the question. From a group of 6 boys M, N, O, P, Q, and R and 5 girls G, H, I, J, K, a team of 6 is to be selected. Some of the criteria of selection are as follows. M and J go together. O cannot be placed with N. I cannot go with J. N goes with H. P and Q have to be together. And K and R go together. Now, the condition states that M and J are always together. Similarly, P and Q, and N and H, and K and R. But O can never go with N, and I can never go with J. Now, the first question says, if the team consists of 2 girls and I is one of them, the other members are. This means there are 2 female members and 4 male members in the team, and I is one of the female members. Now, since I is there, this means J cannot be there. No J means no M as well. So the M options A and D are ruled out. Only B and C are there. Again, option B is ruled out since H and N can never go along. So only option C is left, which is KOPQR. So I would end here. Thank you.